Welcome to Oklahoma Music Legends. I'm your host, Tommy Henshaw. Drummers provide a band's energy, feel, beat, rhythm, and serve as the band's musical timekeeper. Oklahoma has provided the world some legendary drummers. In this episode, we'll discuss a Tulsa quartet of superstar drummers. In no particular order, Chuck Blackwell, Jim Keltner, David Teagarden, and Jamie Oldacre. Stand by for their stories. Chuck Blackwell was born August of 1940 in Oklahoma City. At an early age, his family moved to Tulsa, where he attended school, graduating from Central High School. He shares, by the way, the same high school alma mater as Tulsan legend J.J. Cale. In an interview, he said his music and drumming inspiration came when he first heard Bill Doggett's shuffle rhythm on the 1956 hit Honky Tonk. At 13, he realized he could make more money performing in local clubs than he could on his paper route. He began playing in Tulsa bars and clubs, always carrying a permission note from his dad saying it was okay to allow him to play in these places. You see, he was underage. It was while playing in these clubs he first got acquainted with other soon-to-be Oklahoma music legends, J.J. Cale, David Gates, and Russell Bridges, also known as Leon Russell. Even though they were all underage, they would play together and separately in local bands at various nightclubs in and around Tulsa. After serving one night in Tulsa as the backup band for Jerry Lee Lewis, and while still in high school, he, Leon, and Gates were hired to go on the road as Jerry Lee's tour band. This set the performing fever in motion for all of these young musicians. After graduation, Chuck loaded up all his possessions in Leon's old station wagon, and the two set out, as Leon said in his song, Home Sweet Oklahoma, to chase their dreams in Southern California. For a time, he and Leon shared a place while trying to find their way. Eventually, Chuck's skills as a drummer made him a sought-after musician as a session player. In 65, he landed a steady gig playing in the house band in the ABC musical television show Shindig. Joining him in the Shindig band were Glenn Campbell, Billy Preston, James Burton, Delaney Bramlett, and Leon Russell. Chuck worked with some of the greatest musicians and performers of all time. He toured with Phil and Don, the Everly Brothers. He was the backbone of the Mad Dogs and Englishmen tour with Joe Cocker. He worked with Taj Mahal, Eric Clapton, Jerry Lee Lewis, Little Richard, and of course, Leon Russell, both on tour and in the studio. In the 70s, Chuck tired of the road. He and his wife decided to come back to Tulsa together. They opened a stained glass shop just outside of Tulsa in Broken Arrow, Oklahoma. He continued to perform around the area and for special opportunities. Chuck Blackwell is considered to be one of the co-founders of the Tulsa Sound. He was inducted into the Oklahoma Music Hall of Fame in 2014. Chuck Blackwell passed away in October of 2017 at the age of 77. Our next legend is drummer Jim Keltner. Jim Keltner was born in Tulsa in 1942. He attended John Burroughs Elementary and Roosevelt Junior High. His inspiration to play the drums came in large part from his father. His father was a member of Tulsa's Akdar Shrine and a drummer in the Shrine's marching band and drum corps. Upon seeing Jim's interest in the drums, he recruited Charlie Westgate, also a Shriner and marching band instructor and leader of the Shrine's band at the time, to help get Jim started playing the drums. Jim's uncle played bass for the Johnny Lee Wills band, and his parents would be at the Kane's Ballroom every Saturday night to listen to Johnny Lee Wills and the band play. Eventually, this created friction in the family, so his parents decided for their health and well-being to pick up their little family and move out of Oklahoma and into California, ending up in Pasadena when Jim was about 13. While his main interest in drumming was jazz, the opportunity to play drums in a jazz band were dwindling away in Southern California. It was pop rock in the mid-60s that enabled Jim to break into work as a session player. His first recording gig was playing on the record She's Just My Style for Gary Lewis and his band the Playboys. At that time, Leon Russell was also playing and producing for that band. Jim Keltner is regarded as one of the best session drummers of all time. The list of recordings and the artist he has backed is unbelievable. Unfortunately, this list is too lengthy to announce here. So let me just say this. Bob Dylan considered him the leading session player in America. He's played on three of the Beatles' solo recording efforts: John Lennon, Ringo Starr, and